Swoop on everybody, this is TV, Spark the Bird, and I am going to be playing that on Final Fantasy VII Rebirth today. Some of you that may have been on my channel before and seen that of my YouTube stuff, you would also know that I played that of the remake. And just like, when it comes to that of the remake itself, to not go into too much detail, which is going to give me about like half an hour to explain this thing, Final Fantasy Remake is not the same as Final Fantasy VII, as confusing as that sounds. So, when Square Enix did that of the remake, didn't want to just make a hashtag remake of it and make it look better, so on and so forth. They actually want to do a spin on the story. The story has been altered. As you can see on this screen right now, you have three individuals. The one on the left, that's Cloud. That's the main protagonist that we all know and love. Sephiroth in the middle, he is the individual which has an issue with Shinra because he's an experiment and he found that out, and he didn't much really very much appreciate that. And then we have Zack. Zack is a soldier from that of Shinra, who wanted to be a hero and go through and save people and such. Sephiroth eventually found out his truth in that of Cloud's village, and he had a mental breakdown, at which point that mental breakdown was shit for everybody. Zack himself eventually found Cloud in that village and managed to try and take him back to that of Midgard. Midgard is the place where the remake was held, inside a large city that holds many different floors. A city upon city upon cities, if you will. But Zack, however, died, because secrets that were at Cloud's village were supposed to stay secrets, so Shinra couldn't allow anybody to know about it. Zack was able to get Cloud out of there, but Zack himself lost his life. However, in the remake, Zack himself survived. And in this game, I'm going to lose my shit, because this is the stuff that I grew up on with my uncle. My uncle himself was the only family relative that got games. And the first game he showed me that he loved was Final Fantasy VII. I was so young, I didn't get it. I did not get the story, I did not get the characters. All I remember was some spiky haired guy who used to snowboard down bloody mountainside and everything. And I loved it. And just like, it was fun to play. Just like, I could summon these creatures, these weird and wonderful creatures. Loved the gameplay of everything about it. And just like, but the story, I was too young, it just didn't click. So playing it when I was older and playing Final Fantasy VII, I loved it. And then when Remake came out, I told my uncle about it. We spoke for hours on it. We had our own theories and everything. It was so much fun. And now I'm playing Rebirth because my uncle himself, unfortunately, doesn't exactly have the functions to play games anymore. And just like, he's very slow. His response time with his hand is a lot slower than it used to be, which, bless his soul, he can't really do too much about that. So he actually wanted me to show these streams to him, just like he wants me to download these streams later on, and he wants to know my reaction. He wants to know how I'm taking it, and he wants me to show him later of what they're doing with his game, with our game. So this game does hold a little bit of significance for me, so I will say again, please, no spoilers. Do not spoil me on what is to come. I want to experience everything fresh, new. That's why I'm not even watching Maximilian do it at this point. I'd love to watch his streams, but he's playing it himself. And I need to go through this myself. That is the current situation that I'm doing. I hope you all enjoy this crazy madness I'm about to take. I hope that you enjoy it in your own way. And even if I'm just here by myself, I know that I'm going to enjoy this game because of how much effort and time has been put. Maybe not everybody is into Final Fantasy VII. It's not for everybody. I get it. And just like, it's not everybody's favorite Final Fantasy game. And just like, and heck, I've had fun with other Final Fantasy games myself. And it's like, but this is one that actually holds a little bit of significance to me. So please be respectful, and I don't want spoilers. I'm gonna put that in chat. I hope you can respect my wishes, and that no one will give me any spoilers. You are gonna have to put up with this face, and I do apologize. Also, I'm doing webcam for my uncle's sake and everything to get a picture of this schmuck. Alright, everything is set. Everything is good. I have my drink. Oh, hell yeah, this is a story so far. Booyah. There you go, everybody.
And there is so much to tell.
Whoo!
Where should I even start?
I know, right?
With all Whew. That we saw. We felt this planet.
Hold up.
Our part in it.
Mm-hmm. Everything fixated to be the way of Final Fantasy.
Perhaps.
Fixated to be Final Fantasy VII, sorry.
Midgar, the city of Mako.
What a place.
Ruled by the Shinra Electric Power Company.
Mm-hmm.
Who drained the planet of its very essence, the life stream, and processed it for industry as Mako. Our world was dying, and so few could hear her cries for mercy.
I don't get goosebumps! Jesus!
Those who could rose up in her defense.
I mean, Cloud didn't at first, but you know, he got there in the end.
The anti-Shinra rebels.
Avalanche. Beru!
Cloud Strife, an ex-soldier hired by the Resistance to destroy Reactor 1. In Sector 8, amidst the aftermath of the attack, Cloud met a flower seller named Aerith. She offered him a yellow blossom.
Very key importance there, apparently.
One said to symbolize
a yellow blossom. Understand, that's important. It'll come back later.
And thus was destiny set in motion. With Reactor 1 gone, Avalanche set their sights on Mako Reactor 5. Unfortunately, they were playing right into Shinra's hands.
Yeah, they wanted it to
explode. The company was able to draw the wool over the people's eyes. And in the end, destroyed Sector 7.
Mm-hmm.
Killing thousands and laying the blame at Avalanche's feet.
Yep.
Though dear friends were lost.
People keep asking if I'm back. And I haven't really had an answer. But now, yeah, I'm thinking I'm back.
With her capture, Shinra's obsession was within reach. The fabled promised land. For Aerith was the last of the Setra, the ancient stewards of the planet. And only she could guide them to paradise.
Mm-hmm.
To save her, the team infiltrated the Shinra building, the company's beating heart. It was here that I, another prisoner, joined their story.
Oh, I thought this was a familiar voice. Yeah, this is Red. Red 13. We get to play him in this game.
Yet during our flight, we came face to face with a man thought dead.
Mm-hmm.
The vaunted...
It's not the first time we saw him, though, in that Sephiroth. Game.
Before Sephiroth! Stopped, Cloud's foe fled with the corpse of Genova. Cataclysm from the stars, and the catalyst of our plight. Eventually, we too made good our escape. Pursuing troopers defeated, we raced toward Midgar's edge. Yet Sephiroth once again intervened.
When he shouldn't have.
Suddenly, deafening screams rent the air. Whispers, the arbiters of fate, descended upon the city. Before their imposing wall, Aerith warned us. This was destiny's crossroads. Every moment, every action, every step taken, had all been as the Whispers willed it.
My friends are my power.
To fight them was to break free. On the other side of fate, Sephiroth waited, the Whispers undulating within him. Cloud brought his blade down upon his rival, sundering destiny. The fight won, and the shackles of destiny broken. We stood before the unknown. A world of boundless freedom.
I don't feel so good.
It was there, beyond where fate could follow, that a new journey began.
Yeah. So things are going to be similar to Final Fantasy VII. However, they're going to take a different turn. Destiny, is what they're saying, is this is the story that Final Fantasy VII was supposed to be. Get back on track. So they fought the game to get out of the loop, which is so crazy. That's fucking bonkers, my dude. Magically, No, active. Doing it the new way. I'm just like, did like how that was going. We already in this. Dad, we in. Oh, music. Goddamn.
I'm waiting, Cloud.
He's a prick, but he knows
I'm
what
here
he's
on
doing.
The Midgar Expressway. The scene is indescribable.
Yeah.
Countless buildings have been leveled, and part of the road has collapsed.
And it's our fault, right?
The smoke rising from the rubble is reminiscent of a funeral pyre. Of course, this is only the most recent in a series of crises. Multiple reactor bombings, followed by the fall of the...
You're in the way.
The fall of the Sector 7 plate, culminating in this unprecedented destruction,
mm-hmm.
caused by a massive tornado which swept through Sectors 0, 1, and 2. After a briefing with Shinra investigators, Mayor Domino released a statement, declaring the tornado to be, quote, weather warfare, perpetrated by the infamous insurgent group known as Avalanche. The administration also suspects the involvement of Wutai and has begun investigations into the matter.
Even they know this whole bunch of bull. Yeah, Wutai is a different part of the Final Fantasy world, where they have, yeah, it's the two countries which are currently, like, they're supposed to be at peace, but Shinra's just like, nah, they're making issues with us, because now we have to, like, you know, start war so we can get their resources. Hey, Trophy, how's it going, man? The Mako is leaking. Ooh. Damn! A white feather? I know, the black feather, that's Sephiroth. What's a white feather? He's fucking sick! Oh, shit, let's start us off with this boy!
He lives!
This is only the most recent in a series of crises.
Am I gonna play him?
Multiple reactor bombings, followed by the fall of the fall of the Sector
7. Wait, is he here? He's in us! He's in me!
I got another reactor blew up.
Which must have been caused by the tornado.
Man, when it rains, it pours.
As you can see, over there! Amidst the wreckage of the expressway, search and rescue operations are already in progress.
We still have one suspect.
You're right. Ex-soldier, armed with a buster sword. Highly dangerous.
Repeat. The fugitive is an ex-soldier, armed with a buster
Zach.
Sword.
Zach, your sword.
Back over here.
Get him on board. Prep for takeoff.
The rescue team has pulled people from the rubble.
No. This is there.
Quick, get the camera off him.
So this is Zack's own dimension still. This is his own reality. He hasn't crossed over to ours yet.
Targets have been secured. We are exfilling via Hilo now. Move it! We're taking off!
What?
Hey! Turn that off! The survivors are being taken away! I can't hear you! Oh no, we have a way to kill you!
Dude, they're not looking at you. You want to move.
Excuse me. Could you look after my friend? Just for a bit. Too much Mako. But he'll be fine.
Hey!
Zack just leaving Cloud.
Aerith!
Aerith is Zack's girlfriend, so... Oh! 13's away! Go on, my boy!
Shit!
Okay, that's Artem. There we go. Can't hear anything right now.
Choose your character!
How do I get over there? They're gonna immediately think me, but it's Cloud that they're looking for.
Get away from her! He's got a Buster Sword!
There you go. Hey, how's it going? You wanna start?
Go!
I mean, I'll still learn these buttons, but you know. Zack, what are you doing with the pipe?
Heads up!
Woo-hoo! Yeah, he is a soldier, so...
It's gonna go...
It didn't hit Aerith's one.
Come on, let's get it!
By all means, go for it. Say, you're burning everything, just not me. Night-night. 13, you okay? Aerith! Is she breathing?
Thank you.
Get out of here before more come. Sorry, 13.
Where's the ancient? Heads are gonna roll if we don't find her. Just shut the hell up and search.
Alright. Oy vey.
This is so messed up. All of it.
Yeah. Destiny's been messed with. You should have died.
But I'm back now, Aerith. I'm back.
Is she?
Do you start this off by her dying? He comes back to this? Oh, come on! No! God, fuck. I'm already a fucking goddamn.
All right, then. Seeing as we've got the time.
And now I'm back with the original lot.
You and your buddy
God damn it, that's not fair. He had her.
Me? Yeah, no problem.
It all started 5 years ago. I was 16 at the time. There was hardly any work for soldiers back then. The little there was.
There you go, you get the backstory of it now.
Oh, nowhere. The job of a lifetime.
That's not fair.
A mission. With several. I couldn't believe my luck.
Oh, jeez. All over here. I don't know how many chapters they're gonna be, but I'm already a mess before fucking chapter one, my dude.
It's really coming down, huh? Hey, man. Feeling any better? I'm good.
Remember that man. Remember him.
Wish I could help, but never been motion sick. Sorry, man. Ready to do this?
Yeah, you bet.
Hey, rein it in.
Sorry. No can do.
Kids.
Say, I'd like to be briefed on the mission at some point. Because if it's another one of those Turks gigs, you can let me off right here.
Really?
Finally make first, and what do they do? Call a ceasefire with Wutai, stealing my shot at glory. I didn't join Soldier to be an errand boy. I joined up so I could be a hero, like you.
Well, our mission is to survey a rundown reactor. Another one of those Turks gigs.
Fine. Job's a job, I guess. Where is it?
Nibelheim.
Nibelheim? That's where I grew up.
Got some fiends at R12!
Alright.
Let's go.
Here we go! Oh, you lovely, lovely things.
You take one, I'll take the other.
Understood. I'm gonna take time with my one, if that's okay. Didn't get along with him and he feels weird, but yeah, what the fuck? Huh.
He was in a different league from the rest of us.
Yeah. Yeah, he was. Now we're with the rest of the group.
Nibelheim. That's where they built the first reactor. Right?
Yeah. It all started in the fall. Something was wrong with the reactor, and the whole village was up in arms. Talk of strange new monsters on the mountain only made things worse. People were scared, desperate.
The villagers tried to take care of the monsters themselves, but it was no good. Ended up calling Shinra. So the company sent help. Best they had.
Home sweet home, right? Tell me, how does it feel? I have no home, so I wouldn't know.
You still got parents though, right?
A mother named Genova. She died shortly after I was born. My father.
Whoa there! Genova? Like from the Shinra building?
There you go. Yeah.
Don't worry. I'm getting to that.
Why am I talking about this? Come on, let's go.
Here comes...
Hope I didn't keep you waiting.
Yeah.
I'm Xander, the mayor here.
What's up, Xander?
I wanted to greet you myself, to welcome you to our humble little town. Please, if you'll follow me.
Was it Xander that... let us follow him in the first game?
Consider yourself off duty till sundown.
Oh, thanks. I thought it was Tifa. Because she had the little cowgirl outfit. Oh, it's a good boy.
Please remain in town.
Don't worry. We'll make sure you guys are ready for your hike up the mountain tomorrow.
Oh.
I'm Sephiroth.
Who else gets to be Sephiroth? Or is it always this kid?
Sephiroth this time!
The bloody water tower.
Is it fun being a soldier?
Huh? It's something.
I'm eager to talk to him too, but now's not the time.
Oh?
Don't
oh, Sephiroth's in there.
For Sephiroth.
This is where Cloud and Tifa used to go and talk.
So how did it feel being back up there?
Oh, okay.
I don't know. Nostalgic, I guess? After 2 years away and all that.
Uh-huh.
Tifa knows something that we don't know.
Huh?
There
you went to my place?
Yeah? No!
I figured you might be there.
Is that Cid? I think it is. Yeah, that looks like Cid. There's a cat around here somewhere.
Remember my cat?
Her name was Fluffy, I think?
Yeah. She was always disappearing. And that day was no different.
Fluffy the cat. You went in my room? No. Yes.
You went into my room?
I didn't mean to do that. I she did say it. You went into my wardrobe? You wore my clothes? You did... The piano! Can I play it?
Did you actually play it?
Yes. I just like jamming the keys, like. I just like making that. No, I know there was a tune that you had to do, and it gave you the Dolphin Fists attack with Lyric Break.
Where'd you learn to do that?
Hey, you gotta play for us sometime.
Well, shit, you're a merc of many talents.
You went through my stuff?
Oh, no!
No!
Oh, no!
If that's your idea of a joke, I'm not laughing.
Yeah, me neither.
Come on, Cloud. I know you better than this.